atop the mountain, a spectacular view, allows for a better vision of what is false and what is true. On the sky flashes the golden memories of a life long enough for the fulfillment of age-old reveries, turned into milestones of God's abundant providence. But as I look down to trace my steps that led me here, I no longer see my footprints or the twists and turns in the woods of life. Barely some snippets do I remember, like specks of golden dust in the wind. Enough to make me believe that the climb to the top was not easy, but good. Dusts.
Thank you. Each other first and say, welcome to the family, welcome to the family. This is family here around us. Please say to each other, tap the next door, especially the one you don't know, just tap them and say, welcome to the family. Uy, welcome. Uy, as the Filipino way, uy, welcome to the family. It's good to be with you this evening. I call this my birthday concert. It's kind of like a shameless thing to do, you know, like a birthday concert. What the heck? What the heck is that? But I just feel like I was actually dreading to celebrate or even acknowledge that I am turning 50. And primarily because, I mean, I'm a little kind of wondering about like how much energy will I have at 50? Will I have the same energy I have ever since I have been, you know, roaming the face of the earth and jumping around like a little kid? And I've always been like that. I've always been hyperactive. I don't know when all the pains of my body will start taking over me and I'm no longer able to do all the things that I love doing. Just that, you know, I think it's fair to have those concerns at this time in my life. But I know many people are saying, hey, come on, I know, you don't have to worry about it. Young, 50 is young. It's all about your mind. What your mind can do to you is to think that you're good, you're covered, you're gonna make it. God will give you the grace necessary to be able to do what you have to do. So here I am celebrating 50 years with you all. So thank you for coming. You didn't have to come on a cold November day like this, but you're here because, I mean, you're really family to me, and that's why I wanted to celebrate this with you this evening. So thank you very much for being with me.
Falling. There is a moment when you feel like falling. When your body is not going and everything is just stopping. It is a call from the earth to return what has been borrowed and to surrender what is left that we think we can hold on to. It is in this moment of shedding that we can be our purest self, our truest self, our barest self, without a need for resistance or plea. We instead close our eyes and let everything simply be, to fall upon the arms of Him whose face we longed to see.
welcome your birthday. Once again, the time has come. What a loving gift from Jesus. He has given you one more year. Happy time, your birthday. Happy time is here. What a loving gift from Jesus. He has given you one more year. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. May each day of the year that Jesus is near. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. And many more years to come. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. On your birthday, my dear priests, for all the ways you serve the church so well throughout the year, for all the time you spend to help, to comfort, and to cheer, for all the love you share as God's own messenger and guide, may God bless your life with joy, happiness, and contentment. And may His most special blessings be with you always. Have a wonderful golden birthday, my son. Love you.
I was gonna play in this evening because I made the video, but I did not watch it, so I wasn't sure what was in there. Obviously, I am like my mom. Whenever we express ourselves best in song, that's just my mom, and I love her to death. So, too bad she's not here with us. I would rather have her here. I was always wondering what it might have been like when she gave birth to me some 50 years ago. I only know the circumstances the day before when the Benedictine monk came to our house and suggested that I be named Santos, just like him. And that's why I was supposed to be Sunny. And then because the monk came, I got the name Santos, which is saints. And I don't know exactly how. I never had a chance to really ask my mom what it might have been like when I was born. I know it was the dawn of November 21. But you know, I don't know the details. I just know that I'm sure she had her birth pangs, and that's not easy. I'm a chicken, I don't like pain. So I can imagine birth pangs would be terrible. But through the years, my mother was the one who was the icon in my life that really helped me become who I am today. In every direction, and the entire essence of me is many very much influenced by my mother. So I am here today because of her, and I'm always forever grateful. So too bad she's not here, but I know she's here in spirit. So please pray that she will eventually make it back to the United States. Anyway, thank you, Mama.
Mary Queen, I see you without your crown, down on the ground, with cinders in your sleeve, and sweat dripping round your face. You see me watching you, and you smile with warmth in your eyes, like fire bursting but never burning, glowing but never blinding. Your gentle words fill the air. Come, my child. There's a place for you in my arms. I walk in awe at the thought of your love, wrapping me so tightly, filling me with peace, without words to be spoken. In your holy embrace, cinder is gold dust, and sweat is blessed water. Your arms are heaven. Your eternity, I am loved, and you are my queen forever.
Please welcome Miss Janice Lumanta, my friend.
It's a song about God's love being constant. And especially when we are doubting that God is there, the presence of God is constant. So the words are real. The promise of Jesus is that His love will see us through, that He will be there no matter what happens. And sometimes it's easy to doubt that, especially when we are in the midst of the pain and the suffering. But that is the ultimate, absolute, and most perfect fact of all. That God's love in Jesus is perfect. And He's always there, seeing us through our journey.
When you climb the highest hill,
this, that almost all my concerts have like a message. And this is you and me, sister and brother, saying that the Lord carries all our crosses for us. So give it to Him, He carries it. You don't have to bear it. It belongs to the Lord, He'll carry it for you.
Thank you.
biggest gifts that God has given me is poverty. That might sound strange to all of you, but I grew up poor. I mean, my dad's side, they had some money. They were good, they were comfortable. But my life, when you look at it, especially the years when I was being formed, I was formed in poverty. I was formed in poverty in such that I did not have money to even go to school to take an entrance examination or to apply for college after high school. When I graduated valedictorian of my class, I had nothing. I had no options. My classmates were all going to college, and I was there by the sea, pushing a net by the shallow waters of that South China Sea to get fingerlings for milk fish. All summer long, my skin was burnt, and my classmates were going to the colleges that they'd chosen, and I, the valedictorian, was staying home. That's how poor I was. We lived in poverty. My mom crawled through, especially to my high school, in poverty. In fact, I joined a lot of contests at school. There's English month, anti-drug campaign month, stuff like that. I always join all the contests. I join the singing contest, I join the writing contest, I join the quiz bee, I join all the contests. Because at the end of the month, there is a culmination program, and then they announce all the winners. That's how I rack money for my allowance for the month. That's how poor we were. But we were surrounded with love. And when the river overflowed, our house was flooded. There was water coming into the house because the house was open like this. We go to my kitchen. Our kitchen was made of coconut leaves. So I had to use an umbrella to go to our kitchen to wash dishes. That's how it was in that part of the world, in the Philippines, northern Philippines, when I was very, very young. I was in high school. I couldn't even have a girlfriend because I have nothing to use for dates. Go to show up or impress someone. I didn't have any girlfriend because of that. Whenever I went to school, I was carrying a big Tupperware this time. I made Tupperware look cool because I had my mom's goods that she cooked that morning. I had to take it to school on the tricycle, and I'm on top of the tricycle like this going to school. And that's how it was. I pick up the Tupperware every afternoon, so I went home with an empty Tupperware with money on it. I went to school with a Tupperware full of stuff, goodies. That was all my high school life. But God's love is so powerful. I'm here with you today. And somebody was asking, oh, what kind of gift do you want for your birthday? I'm like, I don't need anything. I really don't need anything. A lot of my stuff are being given away. Like, give away, give away, give away. Even now, I'm like, I don't need it. I don't need anything. So I have been compelled to, because I know what it means to be poor, I've been compelled to kind of, when somebody is saying, oh, there's one guy, I don't even know him, in the Philippines, and he has one daughter, he's like, so cute, but he lost his job. And I meet these people, and it becomes an opportunity to be able to show them how powerful God's love is, because God's love is powerful. I think this song says all of it. It tells everything about God's power. And I'd like to sing this with you all, because I know that you probably know this song, so please sing with me. It's called The Power of Your Love.
Yeah.
Good Friday. Not a plant nor a rose on the linenless altar. The candles all blown off. No statue in sight. I fall to the ground in divine prostration. At all ears, the people join to sentence the innocent Lord. Then the cross of the crucified is carried for the unveiling, to reveal the wood upon which he hung. The world fell in line like a heavenly queue to kneel before the beams of humanity's salvation. Today the Lord died for death, became sin to take away all sin, so far away, betrayed and forsaken on behalf of the condemned. Only the one who is eternal can be pierced by a soldier's lance so that his truth and his way can call upon a soul to rise again. So his sorrow, his death, his passion, that one dark Friday afternoon can be properly remembered in a solemn, ironic declaration. It is good.
Yeah.
You are young. You are beautiful. Say, husband, say to your wives, you are beautiful. Say to your wives, you are beautiful. Beautiful dream. And husband, and wives, wives, say to your husband, you are so dashing, like the day I laid eyes on you. Can you say that? You are dashing like the day I laid eyes on you. Okay, go ahead, Annie. Say it to Dan. Paula, say it to Scott. Oh, come on. Come on now. Ramona, say it. You are dashing as the day I met you. And now give each other a kiss. Ah, that's beautiful. I'm so blessed to be with you this evening and to do this song. You know what? It's now 7:10. I said I'm gonna be done by 7 o'clock. So we'll keep going. Actually, I have just a few more. This song is someone that I really love. Also, I seem to sing this all the time at my concerts. Also, so this is a song that tells us about being at peace, being well within ourselves. And the song is telling us, you know, if you want to have a peaceful and happy environment, you better have peace and joy inside of you, because the outside is a reflection of what's going on inside of you. So any disorder out there that's going on, it says something about what's going on deep within. So order, begin with what's going on inside. Begin with that. As a priest, that's sort of what I've been talking about to so many people all these years. Look for the Jesus inside of you and let that Jesus, you know, compel you to become better, to be a better person, to be an excellent person. So here I am, many years later, I still feel the same way, you know. Let me count my blessings before we sing this song, because one blessing, I was telling these two friends of mine yesterday, that I have 10 blessings. Number one, to be born in life and to be born in faith. That's number one. Number two, my mother. And I guess my family, my friend, my sister is here. Where's my sister, Shasha? I didn't want Shasha, my sister. And my brother-in-law is the one manipulating the thing there upstairs. Aside from that, the church has been with me all these years. It's amazing. And together with the church, you know, I was born on November 21st. That's why I need to pay an homage to the Blessed Virgin Mary here today with Denise. Because I was born November 21st. That's the presentation of Mary. And all my life, the Blessed Virgin Mary has been following me. I was dedicated to the Blessed to be a priest. My mom dedicated me to Mary when I was in fifth grade, and I was so sick at home with some kind of a yellow fever or dengue or something like that. I was sick when I was a child. And my mom knelt on her knee and said, "Mama Mary, I'm giving him to you. I'm giving him to you. Please let him survive this." And the following, like just a few days, I was well. I was back to school. So my mom was always like, "Okay, I have the promise." but I've always been the Blessed Virgin Mary. Like I ordained a priest, of course. I went to seminary here in the States, and it's like Mary. What's that? Mary, or like University of. Our Lady of the Lake, or the Lady of the Lake in Mandalay. And then I went to my first assignment, Mary Immaculate in Plainfield. Where am I today? Mary Queen of Heaven. It's always, Mama Mary has been following me all this time. In fact, when I got ordained a priest, I asked for a chalice. I ordered a specific chalice in Rome. And when I received the chalice, it was a different chalice. I ordered a chalice that had grapes and wheat on it that are sculpted all around the chalice. When I got the one I got, it was episodes of the life of the Blessed Virgin Mary etched on my chalice. If you have a chance, check my chalice over there. It's a Marian chalice. That was given through Bishop Cafford, that late Bishop Cafford. Mary, and so many stories of Mary following me. So Mary, the Church Mary. How many now? Four? Blessing, I have to say, I am surrounded with so many good friends in my life. Look at all these people. And beyond, when I have this all these years, there's so many friends, so many beautiful people that have become enriched, that enriched my life. So thank you for being there, very special. I've talked about poverty as a gift. That's really one of my most important gifts. I learned about God through poverty. I learned about my place in the world through poverty. My love for the arts, whether it be singing or dancing. I was a little child, I was all dancing in the programs in the school. I was in pre-K, and I was in the front of the school dancing. All these years I've been involved in arts, whether it be expressive arts or print arts or anything like that. I've always been a lot of arts. That's why I'm a poet. Those poems that you read today, those are all my poems from the book that I'm publishing today called That's a Goal. So, and also, aside from the arts, the gift of teaching. Am I on number 8 now? Gift of the teaching, the gift of learning, those two things that are so good together, and the gift of joy. I did not intend to be a joyful person, but every time I look at myself, why am I so joyful? Why am I so happy all the time? I don't know, it's a gift. So, sorry if you don't have it. Beg for a gift. Beg for everything into joy. It's so hard to be miserable. I don't know how to be miserable. But you see, life is so short, and at 50, I want to continue to be joyful for the rest of my life. I want to have this disposition of joy that I've always had since I was a child. And so that's one thing that I hope I will never ever lose. And I pray that you all find joy in your lives. And joy is not only when things are going well. Joy remains. But whatever happens in life, joy is constant. It's true joy. So that's my wish. And hopefully, if there's one prayer that I have tonight for you, that you have joy as a gift for my 50th birthday. That you all have joy in your lives. Amen. And the song is called One More Gift. Gift of joy. Gift of peace.
If there's one more gift I'd ask of you, Lord, it would be peace. Thank you.
I got to the final song now. But before I go to the final song, I want to read this poem from this book that I am publishing today. It came as an inspiration during my sabbatical. I was out in the Philippines, and there are a lot of poems here that are written during my sabbatical, but I got an email from a parishioner here at Mary Queen. Her name is Margaret Harrow. She's right there, Margaret. She said in her email, there is this beautiful word. I want to share the word with you. And the name of the word is misocania, she said. And the word misocania means a hatred of new ideas. Misocania. In other words, I don't want something new. I don't want to learn something new. I have hatred towards something that is foreign, that's trying to come to me. In other words, you're stuck in your ways. Somebody who has misocania is somebody whose world is so limited. You don't want to have something new in your life. New idea, new world, new horizon. And I think that's the greatest misery, when we don't know how to grow anymore. And so the poem was inspired by Margaret Harrell's word on misocania. Being open to new things is being open to pain. That's perhaps why you'd rather let no one in. But keeping the door closed is also but a path to pain. The violence of loneliness, the daggers of regret, of not knowing what could have been if only you took the risk of hospitality, even one bit. Opening your door to a stranger is an opportunity for an encounter, where one can get to know the other until the stranger becomes a teacher, and the teacher becomes a friend, and the friend becomes a partner, and the partner becomes a lover, and the lover becomes a healer. The balm that heals all wounds, so that your heart and mind can open wider to your greater, happier world. Misocania. So thank you, because you don't have misocania. When I arrived in America in 2000, I knew no one. I knew no one in this country, except for my uncle, who was kind of strange from me. I did not really know my uncle very well. He was the only one. And I knew names from the diocese, Father John Regan, Father Mario Quijadas. I knew by name. When I came here, I knew no one. I was a stranger. I was no one. I was a new idea. And you all welcomed me. And you all made me part of your life. As you have become part of mine. I remember Tanina when I first showed up here in the U.S. and the doctors, and they're still here, the community of doctors are still here over the years. I remember Tita Manja and Tita Bobby when they came to seminary for the first time to give me food and fix me up. I remember when I went to I was invited to a house blessing, and I was at St. Isidore's, and she is now my soul sister. These two guys, people that I love, all of you all. I look at you and I see all stories, all kinds of stories that I can tell. Stories of the journey. Many of you have been there in pilgrimages with me. Many of you have come to only know this past couple of years, if not only recently. How they left. There was a couple I met in the hospital. When I was doing hospital work, they came. They were here today. We wish me happy birthday. Thank God there's no misocania around. So because of that, I am blessed. Thank you, Margaret Harrell, for showing me that word, and therefore I knew the gift that I have been given. And for all of that, for 50 years of all that has been, to God be the glory. You deserve the honor. God does deserve the honor of applause. This last song is an original composition. This last song is called Glorify. It's meant really to glorify the one to whom glory is due. So if you just feel like rocking it with me, go ahead and rock it with me. It's called a Glorify, everybody.
Glorify, glorify, Jesus, glorify my name.
group that can understand. And to my dear friend, the ever faithful, the ever loyal, and hardworking, Marita Kurnia and her family, Joanne. Thank you. God bless you guys. And all those that have helped. Denise, come on back. Please come here and bow with me, please. Thank you. My dear friend, Denise, come on back. Thank you.